phone.
Elvis Duran. The Elvis Duran phone tap.
And one of my favorite characters in the world of phone taps is Murray the Magnificent, done by our own Dave Brody. Eric is phone tapping his boss, Debbie. You see, Debbie is in charge of the company holiday party for the entire company. She's asked her assistant, Eric, to handle all the entertainment because he has lots of connections. So Eric thought it'd be a great idea to hire the Magnificent Murray, since he's heard the Magnificent Murray on previous phone taps, thanks to our friend Brody. Brody's going to call Debbie to go over the magic tricks he's performing at their company party as the world-famous magician, the Magnificent Murray. Let's listen into today's phone tap. Here we go.
Debbie?
Hi, is this Debbie Yolanda?
Yes, this is she.
Hi, Debbie. Yes. My name is the Magnificent Murray. I'm a magician that Eric hired for your holiday party.
Hi.
Hi, good. Listen, well, good news, the check cleared. It didn't bounce, so that's good, right? We're starting off on a...
Well, I hope not. We are a Fortune 500 company.
And so I have a bunch of tricks I wanted to run by you, and this way you can pick which one's your favorites.
Oh, okay. So what have you got?
The first trick we do is called Magic Mug.
Okay.
And I go, all right, now it's time for Magic Mug. And I wave my hand over this. It's about a 48-ounce mug with a big handle.
Uh-huh.
And I fill it up with eggnog. You know, 'tis the season.
Uh-huh. Okay.
And I drink it down in about 3 seconds flat. What I do is I go, right? And then I vomit all over the people in the front row. I spit eggnog all over everybody.
Okay.
Right?
No.
And then
really?
And then they have the ponchos,
wait a minute,
right?
I'm sorry, really? You do that?
Yeah, it's great because it's eggnog.
It's really a magic trick, though. No,
well, it's not really vomit because it never really went down, but it's more like
I spray
it.
You're soiling people's clothing?
No, I give them
No.
See, that would be stupid. I give them the ponchos.
Okay, but what's to say you're not going to, upchuck it on their face or their hair or whatever? We don't need magic. Mug.
All right. Well, I do a bit called Hanukkah Hands. I'll probably solicit for a Jewish woman to come up on stage.
Okay, why?
Preferably,
why is that important?
Well, for the bit. First of all, why Jewish? Well, my name's Murray and I'm single. You figure out the rest. So Hanukkah Hands. I bring a Jewish woman up on stage and I play Hava Nagila and I get the whole Jewish thing. I put a yarmulke on, I spin a dreidel. And what I do is while she's watching the dreidel, I clap my hands, I wave my hands around her back, and then I reach into her sleeve and I pull her bra out.
I'm sorry. You know this is not sounding like
that's
a fit.
How I met my first wife.
This is not sounding like a fit.
Oh
this
no, it's a great
more
fit.
More like a bachelorette party.
I'm telling you, people love the guys are going to love it. The guys are going to love Hanukkah
you know
hands.
What? No, that crosses into possible sexual discrimination or harassment. I mean, that
wouldn't be no, because I don't work there. See, that's the beauty of it.
No, but you know. I don't think that compliance, I don't think the legal department would find, no, we can't
no,
do
no,
that.
No, because once she volunteers, then it's okay.
No, we can't. We just, it's inappropriate.
It kills.
Please understand, this is a corporate party with the big wigs, from everybody from the mailroom to the big wigs, okay?
Right.
We want everybody to have a great time.
Do you want to have a memorable party? Then if you want a memorable party.
There's a difference between memorable and distasteful, okay?
Whatever. It's not important to me. Listen.
I don't know that we need to offend run the risk of offending people.
Uptight Annie, listen to me.
Hey, excuse me. I have hired you for a job. It was clear what we were looking for, and I don't understand why.
Hey, what you were looking for was entertainment.
You know what? I don't understand. It's like you're purposely trying to jeopardize this gig.
Okay, this is not going to be fun. Okay,
have a good time.
Can I give you no women involved? Okay,
what do you mean, no women involved.
No, my next trick.
Company is women.
Okay, can I tell you about Yule Log?
No, you have not yet.
Let me tell you about Yule Log. It's very easy. So I go over and I grab some food and I say, I'm going to magically transform this food, okay? I take the food, I wave my magic wand, I eat it, I wave the wand over my belly, and without removing my pants, I drop a big brown Yule Log right on the stage.
I don't think that's very funny at all. Listen,
it's
you know
a Yule Log,
this
and then I set it on fire.
Are you crazy?
I set it on fire. You didn't even let me get to the part where I set it on fire. Eric? I want you to call her now and go, hey, did Magnificent Murray call you? How awesome is he? And just whatever she says, just play it off like, no, it sounds hilarious.
All right, good.
Hello.
Hey, did you get here from Magnificent Murray?
That guy is not doing the party. I don't know where you found him. Do you know the kind of tricks that he wants to present at the party? He's going to vomit on people? I mean, what makes you think that's appropriate?
Well, he'll probably do Hanukkah hands with Rebecca.
No. He's not doing Hanukkah hands with anybody. Do you hear me?
He's not doing the party, Eric.
How can I get this through to you?
He's a sensation.
He's not going to give us our money back, Eric. I don't have any more funds for the party.
Donna's going to love him the most, all right?
What?
He lights his crap on fire. Come on. Like, that's great.
You were to hire a magician and a DJ for a corporate party, not a frat party. What are you thinking? That's going to get me fired.
No, it's
going to get you fired, too. What are you smoking, man? We're just going to have to go with the DJ, I guess. I don't know.
He is the DJ, Debbie.
Pardon?
He is the DJ. He's a magician. He's a DJ.
What do you mean he is the DJ? I told you to hire two people. What do you mean he's the DJ, too?
No, he's a DJ and a magician.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. We've got no entertainment, that means.
What do you mean?
We've got no entertainment then because he cannot come to the party at all. We cannot run the risk that he's going to do something offensive.
Yes.
You hired a guy who's going to on stage.
Debbie, actually, this is Dave Brody from Elvis Duran, the morning show, and we're phone tapping you on the radio.
We're taking care of.
I mean, I can come there if you want, but that's not...
You just got phone tapped, Debbie.
The Elvis Duran phone tap. Have an idea for a phone tap? Go to ElvisDuran.com. Click on the phone tap tab. Tell us what you want to do.
This phone tap was pre-recorded with permission granted by all participants.
The